Twitter from this?
Oh, what was this?
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. and by which he gives us a picture of the very communion of Christ and his bride, the Church. God has both established and sanctified marriage, and has promised to bless therein all who love and trust in him, and who seek to give him their faithful worship and service for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy and for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity. Therefore, marriage is to be entered into. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into inadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. So we turn to Holy Scripture to hear what God has to say concerning marriage. The first reading is from the 5th chapter of Ephesians. In this reading, St. Paul defines for us what love is by comparing the husband and wife relationship to that of Christ and his Church. He wants us to understand that love is not something that we can just merely and flippantly talk about, but it becomes an actual commitment, a sacrifice to each other. For that is how Christ sacrificed himself for the Church and demonstrated his love for her and the Church in response to him. So husbands and wives are to offer their very selves to each other in this sacrifice of love, first defined for us when Christ died for us on the cross. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, submit to your husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the Church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Now as the Church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the Church and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant Church, without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In this same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated his own body, but he feeds and cares for it, just as Christ does the Church. For we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is the word of the Lord. As St. Paul harkens back to the word from Genesis, when God created Adam and Eve and established them in their relationship of husband and wife, reminding us that a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two become one. So our Lord Jesus Christ does the same. He uses the same words from Genesis 2 to remind us that in marriage he has a plan. He has already chosen you for each other for this day, and it is his purpose and his intent to bless you and to continue to walk with you as he promised. These words of Jesus from St. Matthew chapter 19. Have you not read that at the beginning the Creator made them male and female and said, for this reason a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Therefore what God has joined together, let man not separate. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
your wife, to live with her in holy marriage according to the word of God? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, be husband to her as long as you both shall live. So answer, I will. Ivan, will you have John to be your husband, to live with him in holy marriage according to the word of God? Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, be wife to him so long as you both shall live. So answer, I will. Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a pledge of confirmation.
As a pledge of confirmation.
Of wedded love and faithfulness.
Of wedded love and faithfulness.
Receive this ring. As a pledge of confirmation. Of wedded love and faithfulness. Grant your blessing, O Lord, to your servants, that they may be ever mindful of their solemn pledge, and trusting in your mercy, abound evermore in love all their days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now that John and Ivan have consented together in holy marriage, have given themselves to each other by their solemn pledges, and have declared the same before God and these witnesses, I pronounce them to be husband and wife in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. At this time, John and Ivan would light the unity candle. As the name says, it expresses the oneness that they now share in marriage. But the two individual candles are not extinguished. They're still individuals, now made one in the mystery of marriage. The Almighty God, abundantly grant you his favor, and sanctify and bless you with the blessing given our first parents in paradise, that you may please him both in body and soul, and live together in holy love until your life's end. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, everlasting God, our Heavenly Father, grant that by your blessing John and Yvonne may live together according to your word and promise. Strengthen them in faithfulness and love toward each other. Sustain and defend them in all trial and temptation. Help them to live in faith toward you in the communion of your holy church and in loving service to each other, that they may always enjoy your heavenly blessing through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, direct and keep you in his light and love and truth all the days of your life. Amen.
Thank you. sharing the chat.
What you're saying when I say
it's still on?
No, it's your birthday. It's your birthday.
It's your birthday.
Sister.
Your sister. Other brother.
Oh, no, it's a brother-in-law. Your brother-in-law lost.
Yeah.
This is John's son.
Yes, he's
your daughter.
Yeah. Your daughter. Oh, okay.